Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online Training Course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to reconcile bank accounts in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now or click the link below for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. Similar to your personal bank accounts, it is important that you reconcile your business bank accounts on a monthly basis. Reconciling is the process of matching the transactions on your bank statement to what you have recorded in QuickBooks. Reconciling your bank accounts regularly will help to ensure any discrepancies between your records and the bank's are resolved in a timely manner, and timely notification of any fraudulent transactions. For example, if you notice transactions listed on your bank statement that you did not authorize, you can notify the bank as soon as possible so that they can investigate. Some of the benefits of reconciling your bank account in QuickBooks are: all transactions on the bank statement get recorded in QuickBooks. Your financial statements, such as the profit and loss statement and the balance sheet, are up to date. Click the links below to learn more about the profit and loss and balance sheet reports. All of the reconciled transactions are marked in QuickBooks as cleared. And finally, you are able to run bank reconciliation reports that will provide the details of the items that have cleared the bank and those that remain outstanding. Before we walk through the steps of how to reconcile, be sure that you have your bank statement handy for the account that you want to reconcile. We will refer to the bank statement often during this process. From the home page of your QuickBooks Online account, you want to go ahead and click on the gear icon located here in the upper right-hand corner. And right below Tools, the third option is Reconcile. The first thing that you want to do is go ahead and select the bank account that you would like to reconcile from the drop-down. After selecting your account, you might see a notification similar to this one here. So if your beginning balance does not match, you will see this notification, which lets you know that you need to go ahead and fix that before you proceed with the current reconciliation. So at some point, someone accidentally probably made a change to a transaction that was reconciled last month. And so now in this example, we've got a difference of $105. Now, the nice thing about the reconciliation process is you can simply click this link that says we can help you fix it and walk through the steps to go ahead and fix that out of balance. You don't want to proceed with the reconciliation until this has been fixed. Otherwise, you won't be able to balance at the end. The next step you want to do is go ahead and enter the ending balance that's on your current bank statement that you want to reconcile to, and also enter the corresponding ending statement date in this field here. If you have finance charges or any kind of interest charges on your bank statement, go ahead and indicate the date here and the finance charge amount in this field as well. And once you've completed all of these fields, you can click the Start Reconciling button here at the bottom. Here is the new and improved reconciliation layout. So let's talk about what's here. Statement ending balance. This is the amount that we just entered in the previous screen from the actual bank statement. The beginning balance is the amount of the ending balance from last month's statement. QuickBooks will automatically populate this field for you. The cleared balance is going to accumulate as you begin to reconcile each item in this screen. This amount will change depending on whether you have selected a payment or a deposit transaction. The payments amount will increase as you select payments to reconcile from the detailed transaction section below. And the deposits amount will increase as you select deposits to reconcile from the detailed transactions below. The difference here is calculated by QuickBooks. It's the difference between your statement balance and the cleared balance. Our goal is to get to a difference of zero. In the transaction section below, you will see all of the payments and deposits that have been recorded in QuickBooks as of your statement ending date. You can filter this section simply by clicking on the tab. So we can click on payments to see just payments only. We can click on the deposits tab to see just deposits only, or we can go back to the default, which shows all payments and deposits. There is no right or wrong way to reconcile. However, I suggest that you reconcile the area with the least number of transactions first. Remember that our goal is to make sure that every deposit and withdrawal listed on the bank statement has been marked cleared in this reconciliation window. To mark an item as cleared, you simply want to click the radio button here in the far right column to select that, and that item will be marked as cleared. So let's say that we want to go ahead and start with our deposits. As we know, that has the least amount of transactions. And so with the deposits, you could actually look at your bank statement and mark each deposit individually. Or if you see all of these listed here, then you can go ahead and click the top radio button, which will select all. And this is just confirming that we want to select all of the transactions listed here. So we'll say yes, select all here. So once you've marked all the deposits in this window that appear on your bank statement, you want to verify that the total deposit amount cleared matches the total deposit amount on your bank statement. So in this example here, our total deposits that we've marked as cleared equal $2,369.15. And if that matches what's on your bank statement, then you are ready to move on to payments. If it does not match, then we are going to cover tips on how to troubleshoot out of balances in just a few minutes. So we'll go ahead and go to the payments tab, and we will repeat the same process of marking all of our items as cleared. Or as I mentioned, you may want to do one by one since there are going to be several transactions here. So you don't want to assume that everything's listed is on your bank statement. So again, we want to verify that the total payments amount here that we've cleared matches our bank statement. So in this example, the total payments equals $1,869.15. You want to double check and make sure that also matches what's on your bank statement. Again, if your withdrawals or payments amount is out of balance, we're going to discuss ways that you can troubleshoot this issue in just a few minutes. Once all of your deposits and withdrawals have matched the bank statement, you should have a difference of zero, which is our goal. So now that we have our difference of zero, we can go ahead and click the Finish Now button to generate our bank reconciliation reports. So when we click this button, behind the scenes, QuickBooks will mark all of the deposits and credits and payments that we've reconciled as cleared. So let's go ahead and run our report. And so you've got the option to just click done and not view the report, or go ahead and view the report, which is what we want to do. And so here is our reconciliation report. And so at the top here is a summary, just a summarized view of the checks and payments that cleared. And then down below, you'll see each individual item for the withdrawals and the deposits that actually cleared. So I want to share a couple tips with you here. The first one is, it's important that you save all bank reconciliation reports for every bank account. The easiest way to do this is go ahead and create a folder. I would suggest one folder for each bank account and save each report. So you should have at least one reconciliation report for each month for each account into those folders. To learn more about organizing key reports and documents such as this, check out our Small Business Bookkeeping Guide. Click the link below to access this guide. Right, my second tip I wanted to share with you is bank reconciliation reports are one of the top five reports that auditors will request. In my experience as an auditor, if you are not able to produce these reports, I can promise you that the audit will not go well. All right, so now let's talk about some troubleshooting tips for reconciling your bank and credit card accounts in QuickBooks Online. Try some of these tips if you're having trouble getting to a zero difference between what's in QuickBooks and what's on your bank statement. Tip number one, if possible, narrow the search down to the transaction type. Figure out if you are out of balance with the withdrawals and payments or deposits and credits. Tip number two, if you are out of balance for deposits and withdrawals, then tackle them separately. In other words, balance withdrawals first and then move on to deposits and credits or vice versa. Tip number three, look for the exact dollar amount that you are off. For example, if your difference is $21.50, then look for a transaction for this amount on your bank statement and then on both the withdrawals and the payments section and the deposits and credits section of the reconcile window. Tip number four, triple check the information that you entered from the bank statement, such as the ending balance and your statement ending date. If either of these are incorrect, that could cause the out of balance as well. Tip number five, check to see if there are any transactions in the reconcile window that you did not select. Remember, if the transaction is on your bank statement, then the radio button in QuickBooks should be marked in the reconcile window. Tip number six, if you do have a transaction on the bank statement that is not in QuickBooks, then you will need to add it to QuickBooks. To do so, just select the Finish Later button from the dropdown to save your work. If the missing transaction is a withdrawal or payment, then you would enter it as you normally would. We explain this more in our lesson on how to create a check in QuickBooks, which is linked below. If the missing transaction is a deposit, then enter it as you normally would. We explain how to record deposits in QuickBooks in another lesson linked below. Tip number seven, take a break. If you've been at it for a while and you need a break, select the Finish Later option to save the work that you have done so that you can easily pick up where you left off. Sometimes taking a breather and coming back can help you spot what's causing the difference quickly. And finally, tip number eight, while it might be tempting, I recommend that you don't click that reconcile button until you have a difference of zero. The problem will not go away. The difference will just carry over to the next month until you figure it out. If you do hit the reconcile button and you've not figured out the difference, QuickBooks will record the out of balance in a miscellaneous expense account called unreconciled discrepancies. Of course, if we're talking about a small amount, $5 or less, then it might be worth your while to move on. At the end of the day, you get to determine what amount you're comfortable with. Reconciling your bank accounts do not change your financial statements. However, behind the scenes in QuickBooks, the items that have been reconciled or flagged are in the check register with the letter R. So let's head over to the check register so we can see that. So we are in our check register, and if you notice in this column, several transactions have the letter R, and that simply means that you have matched these up with your bank statement and these have been reconciled. So one of the things you want to make sure is that you don't want to make any changes to a reconciled item. This is primarily due to the fact that you've balanced it with your bank statement. You can edit the account information if you need to. So for example, if you've categorized something as meals and entertainment, like this item here, and it should have been office supplies, then you can go ahead and definitely make that change because it will not change the actual amount. But you want to make sure that you don't make changes to the date or the amount. If you do, it can cause your financial statements to be inaccurate and you will no longer be in balance with your bank. That wraps up the lesson on how to reconcile bank accounts in QuickBooks Online. To access our full QuickBooks Online course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.